Hello and welcome to episode 48 of the Breaking Yarn podcast. My name is McKaylee. I'm from Albuquerque, New Mexico, and this is my podcast where I talk about my knitting, my crocheting, and my yarn dyeing. You can find me online at breakingyarn.com or anywhere on social media at Breaking Yarn. Today will be the final episode of 2022, so that's kind of crazy. I will have some other videos coming out. I think probably two more before the end of the year, but this will be the last podcast episode for 2022. Thank you so much for a wonderful year and for being here. Please like and subscribe to my channel. I would greatly appreciate it. Today I have two finished objects and two whips. I have kind of a lot of acquisitions because honestly, I haven't recorded a podcast in almost a month, and that's because my family and myself, we've all been sick with the flu. So we took a little bit of a break. I wasn't feeling well on any weekend really to record. I did record a unboxing video for the Mandy's Makings Whimsical Winter box, and I will link that here for you. And I'm actually giving away my second share a pair set on that unboxing video. So if you're interested in maybe sharing a pair with me from Mandy's Makings, please go check out that video. All right, so let's just jump right into the knitting. I have two finished objects, as I mentioned. My first one are these football fade socks that I knit. They're very long. Dun, 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 dun. So I knit these toe up on Magic Loop. Like, who am I? I have never, well, I won't say never, because I have knit one pair on Magic Loop. It was my very first pair. And then half of my second pair was on Magic Loop. And I was just deciding I don't like Magic Loop. And I still feel that way. But I'm amazed that I was able to do this on Magic Loop. I don't have any ladders. Like, I'm a little impressed with myself, I'm not gonna lie. Maybe I've just gotten better at Magic Loop over the years. But this yarn was custom dyed for me. It's a Steeler's Fade from Anna of Zebra Yarns. And it started in this black, and then it fades from dark yellow to light yellow all the way to white. And I did do a little bit of white at the cuff. And then I did an afterthought heel, my very first time doing it. On one of the socks, it went horribly wrong. And I think it's that I didn't get my needles in completely straight. And so then when I started cutting and ripping, it was like some stitches were lower, some were higher. And I kind of had to keep grabbing the stitches with stitch markers. It was a nightmare. But the second one went perfectly, and I made sure that it was in the exact right spot. It was a little difficult, I won't lie, with the single color. There's no like stripes to verify like that my needle is in the right spot because it's all just yellow. So that made it a little difficult for figuring that out. But I used the Afterthought Heel tutorial by Jana of Purl Together. And that helped me a lot to conceptualize it, how to understand exactly what I was doing, because these were true afterthought heels. I did zero planning ahead of time, and I just knit a tube and then a cuff, or from the toe up. So yeah, and speaking of Jana of Purl Together, I was on her and Anne's daily vlog for day 16. I will also link that video in case you want to check it out. They did an interview of me because I was in the C2C to 2023 Advent box. And it's Jana of Purl Together and Anne of I Thought I Knew How podcast. So it was so fun to get to meet them and to talk to them for a little bit. Just about breaking yarn, about my inspiration, how do I come up with the colorways, the name, like all the things about Breaking Bad, and we get into a little bit of color theory as well. So it was a lot of fun. And I also share some news on there that I have not put out publicly anywhere else. So that's my first finished object. My second finished object is this Palm Deco beanie. This is a pattern by Erin Gates. She's Lizzie Knits, and she owns Three Birds Studio, which is where I got the yarn from and the pattern technically. It was a free pattern if you bought a skein of Malabrigo yarn, which is what this is. It's Malabrigo Rasta, my very first time using it. And I will say it was very satisfying, one, to finish a project pretty quickly, but two, to use one skein of the Rasta to get a whole hat, like, and I still had a little bit left over. So I was pretty impressed with that. And this is the Boreal colorway. I don't think I mentioned that, but I think this looks super cute. It doesn't have like a ton of slack or give, but it fits really well and it's a cute design. I don't usually wear like a ton of hats, only when I'm like outside walking maybe and it's cold, or if I know it's going to be cold and I'm going to be outside. So that's my second finished object. I have two whips. This one you've seen before. And guess what? Just last night, I finished the body of the sweater. And I tried it on too. So I'll insert a picture of my try on here. I tried it on last night and it fits really good. And it's not blocked. I think it'll fit even better once it is blocked. Yeah, so let me tell you about the yarn and what I did here. So this all of this yarn, oh, so this is a pattern. It's called Ravello Sweater and it's by Isabel Kramer. And the yarn I'm using is all by Ott Boham Fibers. And this top color here is called Magic. And the variegated color, it might be easier to see when it's wound up like that. So it has the Magic and the next color in it, as well as some like teals, is called Never Ending Story. And I love how it made the stripes, like, obviously they're stripes, but they're not like solidly obvious stripes, I guess is how you would say it. And I did 4 stripes of the variegated with the pink, and then 4 stripes of the variegated with the orange, which is the bottom color, which is called Adversary. It's a very bright neon orange. And then I was getting a little nervous because I only had 1 skein of each color and I'm knitting these sards extra large. I only have like, now I only have less than 5 grams left of the orange. And so I had texted my friend Lisa. I sent her a video like, oh, what do I do? Cause like if I finish out the body in the orange, I definitely won't have enough for sleeves, right? But also I was worried about running out. And so she had the brilliant idea of doing just the ribbing in the variegated colorway. And I think it turned out super cute. I'm glad I did it. I like the way that it looks too. Like, I think it looks cute. And then so my plan for the sleeves, I'm probably gonna do them, I might do them 2 at a time just so I can make sure that I have enough yarn and don't run out on the second sleeve. But I do have quite a bit left of this variegated and I do have some of the Magic left as well. So my plan is just to stripe these two until I get like lower, and then I'll just do the variegated, I think. So that's my plan. It's my Ravello. I'm super excited to have the body done and the sleeves should be done soon enough. I'm excited for that. All right, so that was my first whip. I have one more whip, and this is one you haven't seen before. And it's a new design too, which is really fun. These are my Walter White socks. So I think you can see it. It's a double helix. And there's the strands that go across. Ah, I love it so much. Oh my gosh, I haven't even woven an ends on this first one yet. But I have one sock finished. I just did a slip stitch heel flap and a rounded toe. And I'm actually glad I did the rounded toe because it kind of carried the cable like up a little bit. So it looks really fun. I did a normal like 2x2 cuff. And then the cable just goes down the front of the sock and onto the foot. So this goes back to the design of it is for, this is Walter White. I don't know if I said that. The colorway is Walter White as well. It's a double helix because he was a chemistry teacher in high school. And Walter, as you know himself, was not yet Heisenberg. So he's a chemistry teacher, and a double helix actually was my husband's idea. I was asking him, when you think of Walter White, like what's one thing that you think of when you think of him? And he had said chemistry. And I was like, oh, that's right. And then he said, oh, I always think of a double helix. And I was like, what is that? Because I did not take chemistry. So I looked it up and I was like, oh, that looks cool. I could probably do that in a cable. And so I designed this one. I had to knit it a few times. I ripped it out a few times and started over a few times just so I could get like the spacing of the bars correct so that you could see all four of them. You can really see it more when it's like spread out. And like when it's on a foot, you can see it. But when it's like this, it's a little hard because it just kind of shrinks into itself. But, so that's my first sock, and I have my second sock barely started, like barely started. Just a cuff, and then a few rounds of the repeat. I actually need to unknit a round because I made a mistake, and so I just haven't done that yet. But I will. I will unknit it and then start that round again. So that's my second whip. I also have advents to open. One from Christy of Leap of Faith Yarns. And one is my C2C to 2023 box. I have been filming vlogs for these advents, daily vlogs, so starting December 1st. The C2C to 2023 goes all the way until the 31st. So I will be opening all those days until the 31st. And so the video probably won't come out until the 31st or a few days after, depending on how the rest of editing goes. I've been trying to edit every day as I go so that it's not so overbearing. But we'll see how that goes. And the Leap of Faith Yarns one stops tomorrow. So this is day 24. I figure I will go ahead and open it on the podcast and just include this in the vlog. So, and it's not every day that I get to actually talk. Oh, she puts the inspiration photos as a sticker on the inside. And I know my sister-in-law. So today's her birthday. Christmas Eve, and she's gonna love this inspiration photo. It looks like one of her cats. Oh my gosh, it's a gray kitty. Let's see here. Oh my gosh. So every day she's been giving these cards. By grace, you have been saved. They are always a different scripture. And then here's the yarn for the day. Oh my gosh, that is so cute. I love the gray, but I'm also like a gray fan. I love it. So that was day 24. So tomorrow is the day 25. It's the full skein and we'll be done opening all the minis. So that's exciting. So now I will open day 24 of the C to C to 2023 box. Ooh, pretty. Okay, what does it say? Oh, a shine. It says, OA shine. OA shine. Oation? Oation? Local for Ocean City, Maryland. Photo, Ocean City Fishing Pier. Colorway, Oation. Oation. And here's the yarn. The very pretty, like, gentle lilac-y gray color. It's very pretty. And this was the inspiration for it. Actually, like, I think they're the only ones to include a card of their inspiration. I was like, that's a good idea. I guess I could have done that on mine. Oops. I was day 16 in that box. So you'll have to watch the vlog if you want to see what day 16 was for my inspiration. Okay, so I have a few acquisitions. Oh, and I forgot that I also opened this Stash Yarn Cinnamon Vanilla from Leap of Faith Yarns, one of the goodies for today. Okay, so I have a few acquisitions. This one is really fun though. Let me tell you about it. So I participated in this Just Add Color 2022 with Andy the Knitress. She's the Naughty Knitress. And we dyed up a skein of yarn. So the idea was that she would give each dyer the three same colors, but no other rules. So like you could use any depth of shade. You could apply the yarn or the dye however you wanted to on the yarn. You could dye your skein however you wanted to. The only rules were that you had to use those three colors. The three colors were silver gray, Kelly green, and lilac. And so I had dyed my skein half gray, half of the Kelly green, and then I did the lilac speckles all over. And the experiment that she did, and she did two videos. So there are two videos on YouTube that you can go and check out from Andy the Knitress, the Naughty Knitress. One is where she shows you what the skeins look like. And then the second video is her showing you what they look like knit up. So she knit us a hat and she knit us a sock tube out of the remaining yarn. And then she sent it all back to us. Isn't that so sweet? Okay, so I did mine half gray and half green with purple speckles. So this is how my hat came out. Very cool. I was very obsessed with this. And this could probably even like pull up. I haven't actually tried this on. Oh, cool, huh? She made this on her knitting machine, which is really cool. Yeah, so mine knit up very large pooling sections. It almost looks like stripes, which is really cool. Yeah, so I love how that turned out. And then she also sent me my sock tube, which makes micro striping. It's also like the video is really good for also showing you like if you buy a skein of yarn that looks like this, this is how it will knit up. Just so you can have a good idea of what it would look like in a hat, which is a larger circumference, obviously, and a smaller circumference like a sock. and how different they look, even though they are the exact same yarn. So it's a really cool experiment. Go check out the videos. They were really fun. It was fun to see everyone else's yarn too. It was all a surprise to us. We didn't share what we did. We just sent it all to Andy and she just filmed it all. And then that's the first time we got to see it, was when she filmed it all. But now I have a sock tube. And now that I know how to do afterthought heels, I could make some socks pretty easy out of this. So I'll have to do that. She also sent us, and this was like so surprising, she also sent us, oh, I don't want to show you the code, but a card, thank you for joining, and it had the Just Add Color 2022 on there. She sent us a holographic sticker. She sent us a measuring tape. She sent a pen. And a stitch marker. I couldn't even believe it. She sent us all this stuff just for participating. And it was so fun. It was really fun. And it all came in this cute little bag that she made us too. So I'll link the videos. Go check them out. And yeah, I think it's just a great video in general. Like I said, to know, like if you buy a skein of yarn that looks like this, how is it gonna knit up? Like, you'll have a better idea now what it will look like in different circumferences. Okay, so I have a few acquisitions. I went to Atlanta for my birthday. We went to the Atlanta Falcons game, the Atlanta Falcons and the Pittsburgh Steelers. They played in Atlanta. That's where I wore these socks. And while I was there, I got to meet up with Robin. She drove in from Alabama with her husband, and we got to go to this really cool place called Ponce City Market, and it's in Atlanta. We went there, we found a cool tea coffee spot, and we sat there and drank our tea or coffee and knit for a little while, and then we ventured out. That area is like a really cool like food hall too. And we had some amazing Indian food there. And then she suggested, oh, the Craftivist is a yarn store and it's really close to here. Do you wanna go? And I was like, yeah. So we went to the Craftivist, and while we were there, I picked up two skeins of yarn, and I believe these were all local. So I got a skein of Emma's yarn. And I just loved it. I don't know. I immediately saw it and was like, yes. And it was called Vacay. So how perfect is that? I had to get this skein of yarn for my stash. And then I also wanted to get another one from a local dyer called Ryan Yarn. Ryan Yarn. And it says it's hand dyed in Athens, Georgia. I couldn't decide which skein of yarn I wanted to get. So Robin's husband helped me pick this one. It's called Amaranth. And it's in a twist sock base. So it's an 80-20. I think this is 80-20 as well. Yeah, 80-20 as well. So I picked up both of those skeins from the Craftivist in Atlanta, Georgia. And then I also got this while I was away. This is my skein from PNW Pearls. It's called Cindy Lou, and it's a self-striping yarn. It's a self-striping yarn. I'm excited to use that. I have a few other things going on. I am knitting this sock design. The Zebra Yarns Advent starts tomorrow, and that's for two at a time socks. So I can't really cast on any new socks until I get through that. But because it ends after the new year, you can enter if you're doing the Zebra Yarns Advent, or if you're doing any Advent project after January 1st, you can enter to win prizes for the Adventually Mal 2022. This is the yearly make-along. It's our second year doing it with me. Me and Leah loves to knit. It's any Advent project you want to work on. So whips and FOs from past years, it doesn't matter. Just use it as motivation to finish up your Advent projects. I haven't even started one. I wanted to see what all of my yarn looked like first before I pick a project. I think I want to do the Garter Marler cardigan, but I'm not 100% sure. So I'm just kind of holding out a little bit. I want to get a good game plan in my mind, and I wanted to see what all the yarn looked like first before I decided to plan that out. So I will be waiting to start my Advent project probably until after the new year. So please join us for the make along on that. We have amazing prizes. We have a pattern and a yarn set from CraftNet Yarns. We have a gift card to Mandy's Makings. We have two, I think, one-of-a-kind 50-gram sets from Anna Zebra Yarns. And, of course, we'll have a gift card to Breaking Yarn as well. So those are all the prizes we have for right now. Maybe we'll get some more, and I will let you know what those are as well. But please make sure you join us for that. My last acquisition is the new winter box from Lauren of Granite State Yarns. I'll be filming an unboxing video for it. So keep an eye out for that video as well. I will link it up here if I've already filmed it and put it out. All right. Thank you so much for joining me for episode 48 of the Breaking Yarn podcast. I really appreciate you being here, and I'm so glad we were able to spend a little bit of time together. And I hope you have a great day, a great week, a blessed rest of the 2022 year. We'll see you. Bye.